There is a place west of the prime meridian, chiseled from limestone, rich in culture, tradition, and birthplace of perhaps the world's most undiscovered sportsmanships. A game rooted deep in the ghettos of Barbados.
Road tennis is an indigenous sport.
Road tennis is mental, physical, emotional, it's everything. It's a complete sport.
And in those days, it had seemed as only a downtrodden sport. So government never saw it as something tangible.
If they don't be careful in Barbados, they will lose the sport.
So we used to get any piece of wood, then and cut out the handle to hold, and then that was our rackets.
Tennis is not a hard sport to learn, and if what you put in, you will get out of anything you do.
There are four strong styles in road tennis. It's the attack, the chop, the defense, and the volley. Now, out of those four styles, one style beat all, which is the attack. To really master the art of road tennis, first thing, you have to love the sport. And by loving the sport, you have to practice.
When I found tennis at 12 or 13 years old, it became something that I knew I wanted to do. Children where I came from in the Gap, in the village, all played road tennis.
You have to do a lot of thinking on the court when you're playing. Physically, road tennis builds my body, gets me faster and sharper.
I got to play against a couple of Grand Slam champions. When I played the Davis Cup, years later, I played against Andres Gomez from Ecuador. Fortunately, I was able to achieve those dreams, becoming a Davis Cup player for the Caribbean and later for Barbados.
I would prefer to see the government of Barbados. They try football, they try volleyball, they try a lot of things. And there are not much success in a lot of the sports that they try. I think road tennis is a game that they could go far with.
We have the players, but a structure. We have tennis playing in Barbados in schools, but we only have six road tennis, six juniors playing the game. This is very poor. I'm looking out for the future as well.
I love the sport, and it's always good to do what you love, because that way it makes it easier as you work, because you're not looking at it as work, because it comes easy and natural to you.
Don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the-